Hi, everybody. I'm Marisela from KLRN's Education Department.
And I'm Mary. Welcome.
We're really excited to share information about the Watchers of Texas program with you all today. So without further ado, we're going to share our screen so you can learn more. So let's begin. The Watchers of Texas program is administered by the University of Texas at Austin and distributed by DISCO Learning Media. The program is sponsored by the Texas State Energy Conservation Office, as well as the U.S. Department of Energy. There's additional support from ITRON and CPS Energy too. KLRN is working to support the program as a partner with this initiative. We are working to engage students and teachers to be ambassadors and adopt elements of the Watchers program that will help them at their campuses. So, what is Watchers of Texas? It is an energy efficiency program designed to help schools and families save energy and money. Founded in 1985 as Watchers of Texas, the original program focused primarily on student patrol groups assigned to areas of the school, checking for energy waste in the form of building lights. If students find lights on in empty rooms, they would leave tickets and remind people to turn the lights off. Over the decades, Watcher energy patrols have saved participating schools around the state from hundreds to hundreds of thousands of dollars in energy costs each year. In 2018, Watchers relaunched as an updated version of the original program that builds upon the patrol program and related materials. The digital program design allows teachers to have easier access to materials. Additionally, the digital platform can continuously and seamlessly update and will help save material costs for districts. Designed to go deeper than just turning the lights off, students, teachers, and families will now have the opportunity to learn about energy conservation and cost-saving tips through modern, everyday categories such as food, water, and transportation. So now we're going to share with you a 45-second clip about the resources that are available.
Watchers of Texas is a free smart energy program that teaches students about conservation and sustainability and helps schools across our state save money and energy. Teachers, it's everything you need to implement a successful smart energy program in your classroom. The curriculum includes more than 100 project-based lessons and activities for grades kindergarten through 12th that are already aligned to the TEKS state standards. Students, you can become Watchers in the Student Patrol program as you join Lil Tex and Ann to round up the Wasters gang. Visit Watchers of Texas because Texas is too good to waste.
The Watchers of Texas is a behavioral program, and the website provides the materials to launch and maintain a robust experience at your campus or district. It is not an audit program, nor is it an application to track your school's energy savings. We recommend working with your district administration and your facilities or energy managers to help you track your progress.
So Texas is too good to waste. Through the program, students, teachers, and families will have access to energy-saving tips, activities, and lessons. Launched in 1985, Watchers of Texas is an updated resource that builds upon the original beloved program and provides a modern look at energy, sustainability, and conservation. Our goals for today is to better understand how important energy efficiency is, explore the resources of Watchers of Texas, and discover ways to get involved. Who can participate? Students, teachers, families, anyone can use the online website and form a Watchers of Texas patrol. An example could be a classroom studying an energy unit, an energy-related extracurricular group, or even a service organization or after-school program. Parents and community leaders may also use the activities or lesson plans contained on the site to inform a conversation about conservation or to save energy and money outside of school. The training and support necessary for the Watchers of Texas program are absolutely free, thanks to the funding from CECO, U.S. Department of Energy, and ITRON and CPS Energy. And they are all available on this site. Explore to find curriculum supplements, lesson plans, and projects for all grades K-12, and much more. Why should administrators and staff work to save energy? One answer is money. Reducing school energy costs can increase dollars available in the school district budget for educational uses. A portion of the savings may be returned directly to the school as an incentive. But whether schools receive rebates or not, students and staff learn energy efficiency and everyone wins. From a global perspective, saving energy saves natural resources and reduces associated environmental problems. Think about how you are currently working to reduce school energy costs. If you haven't started, what ideas do you have that would be quick and easy to implement? Jot these ideas on a piece of paper that you can come back to. Why should students be involved? Well, energy efficiency is everyone's responsibility. We call this energy literacy. School is a significant part of the student's world, and the Watt Watchers of Texas program is a proven method of teaching energy efficient habits while reducing school electric bills. Our energy future depends on decisions students will make about energy use. Watt Watchers gives them the opportunity to make a difference now by doing something for their school.
So how can your school start using the Watt Watchers of Texas program? There are four easy steps. One is you're participating today to learn more. Two, you can visit the website, watt-watchers.com. You can also use materials in your classroom and in your programs, and you can tell someone else. The website includes a sequence of steps for organizing and implementing student patrol programs, as well as tickets, thank you notes, patrol records, student contracts, and other materials for teaching and motivating students and staff. You can copy and distribute the material as freely as needed. Remember, it is all free for your school. Even if student patrols are not the right fit for your school or the semester, the wide range of lessons, activities, and projects can supplement in-class teaching and learning and take the lessons learned into the real world. The assets are also available in English and in Spanish. Now we're going to share a short video example of how students use a patrol program to save their school money by saving energy. This is from Pflugerville ISD Student Patrol Program.
The first student will go down to EDP, Miss Norris and Miss Roach. The point of Vault Watchers is to conserve energy and resources to save money.
Electricity costs a lot, and so we're trying to save on that.
We do is make sure all the lights are off, and if not, then we'd give them a ticket.
You will walk around a hallway or a part of the school with a clipboard and a basket, and you will peek through the window of the door.
And lights are in use. Okay. X means there's lights on, but there's no one in there. We are putting in a VAD card, so next time they come in, they'll remember to turn off the lights.
I think teachers feel like maybe it might not be their fault.
They must feel like, I need to do better next time.
But they might just tell the class and give them a reminder that we left the light on and we're trying to save money, so next time, guys, just turn the light off when you leave the classroom.
Since I started, I've noticed a huge change. There's been a lot of teachers turning off their lights now. I haven't seen a lot of X's this year.
Because they noticed that they might have been getting cards more often last year, and they're trying to be maybe more responsible.
I feel good, because I mean, that means they're actually paying attention in the first place. It's kind of a habit for me now. Like, when I go into rooms and go out of rooms, it's kind of habitful because I usually, like, I'm always having my hand out turning off the lights.
1, 2, 3, Watt Watchers!
So we would definitely like to welcome and thank Pflugerville ISD for supporting the materials in the program and also sharing this resource with everyone.
So what if you need more materials or help? So we are here to help you. You can first download and print any materials for free from this website. You may want to keep in mind, though, the environmental implications of printing and reprinting online resources. If you do need further assistance, you can contact us by email. You can contact me, Mary Campos, at mcampos@klrn.org, or contact@watch-watchers.com. We will update this site routinely with updated information regarding teacher training, events, or updated resources.
And now we're going to look at the program, and we're going to introduce you to some characters. The first two are Lil Tex and Ann. They are the Watt Watchers, and they are the heroes of our story. They live by the motto, Texas is too good to waste. They love Texas and are dedicated to conserving her resources. The Student Patrol program is the heart of the Watt Watchers of Texas. Your students will join Lil Tex and Ann as official Watt Watchers, helping to save Texas by rounding up the Wasters gang. Tex and Ann are targeted toward younger students, but they are appreciated by all. We're also going to introduce you to the Wasters gang, and these are the bad guys. Anytime you see a light left on in an empty room, water running from an unused faucet, or recyclables in the trash, you know the Wasters gang is nearby. They are not evil per se, they simply don't care about anything but themselves. Like any good comic book villain, they can be defeated but never eliminated. They'll always be back in the future.
So the Watt Watchers of Texas materials are arranged into six topics. First one is electricity, there's water, materials, cooling and heating, transportation, and food. And the activities are part of the Watt Watchers program are found at www.watt-watchers.com/activities and listed as a table on this page. You can sort by category, such as electricity, water, materials, etc. Once you click on that, you'll see the title with a short summary of the lesson activity. And you can also click on the activities by grade level and see all the lessons for that particular grade. Or you can also click at the bottom to see the list of all the activities. If you are looking for materials related solely to the Student Patrols program, use the link in the main page from any page. This is a sample landing page for activities that you'll find if you are searching for resources for your third grade classroom. You'll see the grade level or levels it is designed for, the theme you'll explore, materials you'll need, and instructions for the procedure, and even some extension ideas. And just remember, all activities are TEKS aligned.
So within the six content areas, there are activities and resources for you. Conserving energy is a central theme of the Watt Watchers program, and one of the most tangible ways to save energy is by saving electricity. For example, within the content theme of electricity, articles that exist include the Student Patrols program, as well as projects related to turning off the lights, monitoring computer power, and measuring and auditing consumption.
Now, conserving energy through water. On its own, water is a necessary and precious resource, necessary for drinking, cooking, cleaning, cooling, and other processes fundamental to life. Water is a human need. However, like all other resources on Earth, water is limited. As global demand continues to rise, the availability of the water resource will not rise with it. Conservation is one way to help ensure there is enough to go around. Further, energy and water are tightly linked because society uses energy for water and water for energy. Saving water is one way to save energy and vice versa. And conserving energy through materials. From its source to you, each and every material you touch requires energy at every stage of its life cycle. The raw materials for cans and bottles are extracted from earth and transported to manufacturing facilities where they are refined, molded, and repackaged before being transported to other facilities to be filled with food, drink, household goods, or other useful things for your use. More transportation takes them to your local store where they are stored and possibly air conditioned before you pick them up to use them. Removing materials from landfills and moving them back into the consumption cycle, which is recycling, helps cut energy use from its process. Recycling can be done at a local level for a big impact on overall energy consumption. Conserving energy through transportation. So transportation makes so many things we do every day possible. Attending school outside of your home, eating food not grown in your garden, visiting friends or family that do not live in your neighborhood, countless jobs, and global commerce all depend on transportation. The transportation sector, including all forms and modes, consumed about 20% of all energy globally in 2015. As such, efficiency in transportation represents a large potential to save energy in modern society. So conserving energy through food. At its basic level, food is a form of energy. Our bodies convert chemical energy stored in food to kinetic energy through a series of complex physical and chemical processes. In turn, this kinetic energy powers our muscles and lets us move. Beyond food, agricultural operations, processing, packaging, transporting, refrigerating, and preparing food all require energy. All of that energy goes somewhere, and some of it is used. The rest is waste. As a result, one of the ways to save energy is to save food waste and other energy waste in the food system from the fields to your plate. So now we have the energy trip ticket. So to give you some background information, students use energy every day without thinking about where it comes from, how it arrives, or even that they are using it. This activity will help to make students aware of their energy usage by making them pay for each energy trip they make throughout the day. This activity will also get students thinking about ways they can conserve or eliminate energy use by making them look at their day. So to set the stage, have the students make a list of all their school trips that they do throughout the day, like to the pencil sharpener, to the lunchroom, the restrooms, music class, and so on. And the energy trip ticket game, you give each student 15 energy trip tickets and announce that for the next 5 days, every trip will cost one ticket. At the end of each day, record the number of tickets each student has and has left on a large chart for all to see. Who's wasting energy? Who's conserving it? How are they doing it? Discuss energy saving strategies such as combining several errands on one ticket and pencil pooling, which is the rotating the task of pencil sharpening within a small group of students. By the third day, the room will be abuzz with talk of the impending energy crisis. So the discussion you can have is to ask your students what effect the crisis is having on their standard of living. Now they are ready to devise some real life conservation strategies. Developing conservation strategies can be fun, especially when your students know the priceless reward of their knowledge of energy conservation. And as an extension, you can have students write down their energy trip conservation goals at the end of the week. Have them keep track of their energy trips for the next week and see how they did and what modifications were necessary to meet those goals.
A second example of an activity is from the water conservation at home activity. It is for grade levels kindergarten through second grade. Did you know it takes energy to run water? Water is a precious resource, and wasting it not only wastes water, but energy too. Reducing water waste saves water, energy, and money. Did you know heating water alone counts for an average of 15% of total household energy use? Conservation is a careful utilization of a natural resource in order to prevent depletion. When we conserve water, are careful about how we use it, we decrease water and energy waste. You can try many different steps to reduce your water waste. You can skip the bath and take a shower. A bath takes at least 15 gallons of hot water, and most baths use between 35 and 50 gallons. Taking a shower instead can reduce the amount of water and energy you use. The average shower runs at 2.1 gallons per minute and lasts only 8 minutes, using a total of 17.2 gallons. Long showers can also use just as much energy and water as a bath. If you reduce your shower from 8 to 5 minutes, you can save an average of 6.3 gallons a day. That's almost 2,300 gallons a year. You can also turn the water off while you brush your teeth. If you brush your teeth for 2 minutes, that wastes between 1 to 3 gallons of water every time you brush your teeth. It may not seem like a lot, but brushing your teeth even once a day wastes between 365 to 1,095 gallons a year per person. Turning the water off while you brush your teeth saves a lot of water. You can also be intentional about your laundry. Laundry is the second largest drain of water in your home. Being intentional about washing your clothes right, using cool water and making sure you don't wash small loads. If you are intentional about washing clothes in the right loads, it can reduce the amount of water you use for laundry. Remember, don't let the water run. Do you do the dishes by hand at home? The average kitchen sink uses 2.2 gallons per minute. Filling the sink up with hot, soapy water and rinsing the dishes all at once will help reduce the amount of water you use. You can also reduce your outdoor water consumption. Learn what plants and flowers grow best in your climate. Planting something that needs a lot of water when you live somewhere with only a little rain means using more water. There are so many different activities you can use and information you can share with your students and your family. We encourage you to explore the activities on the website.
Promoting enrollment at your campus. What does participation in the Watchers of Texas program look like for these audiences? You, your peers, student ambassadors, and student club organizations. Think of one idea of how you can promote involvement. We would love to hear from you. Remember, we are here to support you, and so contact us at any time with any questions. Again, my email is mcampos@klrn.org. Tips for launching Watchers of Texas. Huddle ISD cut costs by over $318,000 using the Watchers program. If every district in Texas used the Watchers program, it is estimated that over $14 million would be saved each year. So you can promote district-wide support, create student-teacher leadership teams at each campus, also empower students to lead the charge, reward students and schools, and engage them in friendly competition. Use the free lessons and activities in your classroom, and use the Student Patrols program. Save energy, save money.
So before we wrap up, we want to share with you another example rollout, this time from Cypress Fairbanks ISD, northwest of Houston. They have implemented a district-wide energy savings program called Campus Energy Education Program. It uses the Watchers program as a foundation for student education and school energy savings. CyFair, as they call themselves, has over 50 elementary schools. So now we're going to take a look at their website. On here, you can learn more about how they're integrating the Watchers program and about the level of responsibility that they assume together. You can also learn how it works. You can have information about the program savings summary, which is pretty impressive as a tool that you can use to share with teachers and your campus administrators as well. And then you can also hear from teachers themselves about why Watchers participation is important and what they're saying about the program. For example, Kristen Paulson Robinson says, "Our kids have been so excited about their patrols. They can't wait to find more ways to save energy on our campus." Here, you'll see some pictures or some photos from the student patrol members themselves. It's pretty exciting to see so many people integrating the resources. And lastly, you'll see here some examples of what they're doing as far as messaging at their campus. So some great news from SciFair schools, and the last photos and text shows that SciFair received a $200,000 rebate in January after starting the Watchers program in September 2018. Students at SciFair schools receive official Watchers t-shirts made by their teachers and schools. This is a great way to promote teamwork and championing energy savings.
So Catherine Tubbs from Lowry Elementary School said this, "At Lowry, our Watt Watchers do patrol during their independent reading time. This ensures that we are checking the school at many different points during the day. The Watt Watchers sign up for a day of the week to patrol and the areas they patrol. Change every week. They said they wanted variety. We have between 4 to 6 patrols done each day at a variety of times this way."
So we need your feedback. We ask you to answer a short survey for us, and it can be found at bit.ly/WWOTKLRN. When we receive your survey, we will update your registration and send an electronic certificate for your training. So in closing, we definitely want to thank you all for being here with us today to learn about the Watchers of Texas program, because Texas is too good to waste. And we definitely want to talk about our partners and thank them, Disco Learning Media, UT Austin, the Weber Energy Group, as well as those who help to support financially and with sponsorships, such as CECO, the U.S. Department of Energy, ITRON, and CPS Energy. Thank you very much for being here today. Once again, we can't reiterate enough how important it is to share this responsibility with you all. So if you have any questions, please do reach out to us and learn more on an ongoing basis. Thank you very much.